Richard Baker graduated from Ames College, worked at Ames Laboratory, and then for a company in Chicago as a physical chemist. At age 25, he was recruited to work on the Manhattan Project, but he was not told what he would be doing or where he would be doing it. He remembers J. Robert Oppenheimer showing him a postcard of Ashley Pond with mountains in the distance.
They couldn't tell me a great deal. They just told me that it was a very vital defense project, and they told me that it was, from a technical point of view, very challenging, and that they would have no trouble of putting me on leave of absence with the company. Well, pretty much I joined the project on just the what they told me, that it was very important and would be challenging. What you did when you started out here like that was you just put your faith in the people that had talked to you, because you really didn't know what you were doing or where you were going. I'd never been in New Mexico. And the only thing that I recall about that was that Oppenheimer had a picture with him that was taken during the ranch school days here that showed Ashley Pond over here, and it had two swans floating around on it and a canoe. This was taken when the boys were here. Well, it looked pretty good, and then it looked you could tell by the picture that was in the mountains, you see. And by the time I arrived here, Ashley Pond, due to construction, had been reduced to just one great big mud hole. No swans or no canoes. They were drawing water out of that for construction purposes, you see. And the interesting part of it was that coming out here through dry New Mexico, I was wondering where all this water, this pond and the swans was.